Hello class, and welcome to the week 10 video. In this video I'm going to be discussing the assignments and the readings for the week. I'm really happy that, you know, we're about two-thirds of the way through the semester at this point, and the finish line is going to be in sight. If you are watching this video at the beginning of week 10, you know, we're about two-thirds of the way through the semester. And this is a really important week because you're going to be turning in the final draft of your discourse community analysis. And that is really your biggest concern this week as you are preparing the final draft of your discourse community analysis. This is going to be due along with your journal entry reflection at the end of this week. Please make sure that you are taking your time and coming to me with any questions as they come up. There is only one short reading this week from the textbook about the revision process. Since you are completing a revision of your own, I thought this was a very fitting article for you to take a look at. So week 10, you kind of have a full week with the discussion board, a journal entry, and a one-pager. Weeks 11 and 12 will each have slightly lessened workloads, as you only have two assignments due each of those weeks, as you will, one of those weeks has a another mental health break. What should you be doing this week? You should be making an appointment with the CWC if you are having any issues with the discourse community analysis. That's something that I would make sure that you do as soon as possible, is to make sure you make an appointment with the CWC, make a Skype appointment with me next week, this being week 10. Tuesday through Friday. I'm going to be very busy on Monday of week 10 working on drafts for my 1020 classes. So I'm not going to have any Skype availability on Monday, but if you do need to meet with me, you can do so Tuesday through Friday. Make sure that you are rereading over your work out loud. You have to do this more closely, especially if I wrote this on the comments for your first draft. Make sure that you refer to the videos and the assignment sheet. And also make sure that you are checking out the student examples and reading through those thoroughly multiple times if you need to. So there are a number of links that I posted under week 10. Be sure to refer to the links that I have posted this week, as two of them relate to a consistent problem that I have noticed for students. One of those is about apostrophe usage, and the other is how to punctuate titles properly. So make sure that you look at those two links on how to do those. The other two links relate to citations. The final draft must include a works cited page. And you can use the links provided on eCourseWare for guidance. Potential options include you may be citing personal interviews, or you may be citing electronic sources. But again, you must have a works cited page. Even if you end up interviewing only one person, you do need to have a works cited page for just that one person. That is extremely important. So if you have any issues or problems or questions about the works cited page, that is another thing that you should be asking me about. Because students who do not have a works cited page, again, even if it's one source, you will lose points off of your grade if you don't do that. So again, the reading that you are completing for this week is entitled Strong Writing and Writers Don't Need Revision. The essential thesis of this piece is that good writers have trouble with writing just like students. These are ideas that have been proposed in other texts that we've read through. Part of what you are also doing is understanding that revision and proofreading are two distinct aspects of the writing process. Revision covers ideas, purpose, and organization. These are what I like to call a kind of big picture or global issues. But then there is the idea that proofreading covers grammar and mechanics. Proofreading is a lot of your lower level concerns, anything that has to do with basic sentence structure and grammar. But really what I think a lot of you need to be doing is thinking about how you're actually going to revise your papers. You know, for some of you, it is a proofreading issue, but for a lot of you, it comes down to revising and thinking about your ideas. And also something that I think we often lose is the idea that the writing process is not one thing to all people, but that the writing process is very fluid and different students can have different approaches to the writing process. So that's also something to think about. And understanding that while revision is important, the writing process is also finite. Like, at a certain point, you have to turn your paper in. And that's at the end of week 10. At the end of week 10, you do have to turn in your discourse community, whether you are fully satisfied with it or not. There is a process that you do need to take hold of, and you need to complete the process. So, you know, I think it is very important to revise as many times as it takes until you feel you're satisfied, but that ultimately you do have to turn your paper in at some point. So the discussion board for this week, before completing the discussion post, again, make sure you are doing this reading about revision. In her piece, Giovanelli treats revision like Lamont treated her first drafts. She shifts the conventional wisdom about how writers should regard this aspect of the writing process. What are some of the takeaways you have from this essay? How has this class changed your perception of revision? And do you feel you had an understanding of revision before this class? So please post initially on the discussion board by Tuesday, March the 23rd, by 10 p.m. And the two peer responses should be posted by Thursday, not Sunday, because I don't want you to have to turn the discussion posts, the journal entry, and the final draft of your discourse at the same time. So I have shifted the discussion board peer responses. Those need to be turned in by Thursday, March the 25th. So the journal entry, so just like you did with the literacy narrative, you will complete a reflective journal entry on the discourse community essay. Please try to have this be about a page long in an essay format. And you're going to answer all of those questions that you see there. Just answer it in an essay format, just as you did with the literacy narrative. And please have this journal entry posted by Sunday, March the 28th at 10 p.m. Okay, that's all you have to do. Just like with the journal entries for the literacy narrative, I'm not necessarily going to provide individual feedback, but students who turn this essay in, they will receive full credit basically automatically, and the general feedback that I provide will be contained in an email. So the final draft of the discourse community analysis will be due in the Dropbox by Sunday, March the 28th at 10 p.m. If there is going to be an issue turning the final draft in on time, be in touch with me as soon as possible. There is no quiz or anything else to complete before being able to turn the essay in on time. I don't think it's fair to have you do that for the final draft, so I'm not. But make sure that you turn in the final draft. Make sure that you take in my feedback seriously. Make sure that you visit the CWC. Make a Skype appointment to discuss any issues that you have with me, and I will be happy to work on those with you. But otherwise, I hope everybody has a good, safe, and healthy week. And that's pretty much it. Have a good one. Bye, everyone.